If things had gone as I'd expected, Joe Biden would have been the Democrats' 2016 presidential candidate. If things had gone as I'd hoped, John Kasich would have been at the top of the Republican ticket. If those two things had occurred, I am certain that I would have voted for Kasich. No disrespect toward Biden, but he had at least two check marks against him, his age and his political party. Back in August 2015, the primaries were just getting underway, and I had been a registered Republican for more than 36 years. And while there were aspects of the Republican Party with which I disagreed, specifically anti-marriage equality and an overemphasis on Christianity and conformity being an essential element of American life, they were still the party that touted decency, law and order, and fiscal responsibility. Hey, Republicans were the grown-ups in the room, plain and simple. Things did not go as I'd expected. Joe Biden lost his son, Beau. And the grief of that loss was too heavy a weight for Biden to bear. He didn't run for president, and in the end, Hillary Clinton won the Democrat nomination. The only item working in Clinton's favor compared to Biden was her age. Clinton was 69 years old on November 8, 2016. Joe Biden was just shy of 74. Biden was an old man, a definite demerit in my book. Clinton versus Kasich? I'd be doing what I'd done 7 out of 8 times since my first presidential election. I'd be voting for the Republican at the top of the ticket. It didn't turn out that way, of course. And as I'd watched the first Republican debate in August 2015, I'd laughed at the joke that is Donald Trump. The joke of the debate, and the next debate, and the next. Still, I knew Trump would be swept away with the first-in-the-nation Iowa caucus and first-in-the-nation New Hampshire primary. I knew, but I knew wrong. Trump came in second in Iowa and won by a landslide in the Granite State. Kasich managed a second-place New Hampshire finish but didn't even get on the scoreboard in Iowa. I was still laughing, but now I was laughing at Republicans as well as Trump. What a joke! Get on with choosing an acceptable candidate. By the time my turn came to vote in the primary, Kasich was out, and I cast a Hail Mary vote for Marco Rubio, not because I wanted him, but rather because I was not going to vote Trump. In the end up, I wound up voting Clinton, something unimaginable to me prior to being faced with the choice of a woman I despised but felt had leadership qualities and a man I loathed. Prior to voting, I began a very vocal call to everyone to vote Clinton, not because my mind had changed about her, but rather because I could not imagine a less worthy, a more heinous, crass, and self-serving president than Donald J. Trump. Donald Trump lost the popular vote, but won the electoral vote fair and square. Trump was in. I was deeply disappointed, but figured 4 years of incompetence could be endured. Little did I realize how evil, divisive, and self-serving would be Donald Trump's reign as president, and how the embrace of him would cause me to abandon my political party of nearly 4 decades. This month, I had 2 friends confide to me for whom they voted in 2016 and in 2020. One, a lifelong Republican like me until Trump distorted the party into an instrument of chaos and hatred, voted Clinton and Biden. He, too, seeing through the Trump hysteria and hype. The other, a lifelong Democrat, surprised me with his confession of voting Trump in 2016, but going Biden in 2020 because of Trump's lies, his poor governance, his shredding of the constitutions, Trump's hate-filled and lie-fueled Stop the Steal coup attempt, prompted him to confess his sins to me and to acknowledge the need and urgency of making an America based on truth and light. I'm still not a Democrat. I have been a non-affiliated independent voter since late 2017, but I voted 100% Democrat in both the 2018 and 2020 elections, something I'd never dreamed of doing prior to Trump, as I had always selected candidates based on position and record as well as political party. For 2 years, I have been proclaiming that the Republican Party must die. The party, not Republicans. The Republican Party stands for nothing that makes for greatness. Rather, it is evil incarnate, and I hope it is soon replaced by a conservative, thoughtful party that works towards making a better USA, a party that stands and works with Democrats to create a far better future than any mislabeled, misguided yearning for a nostalgic greatness that never included all and was ballyhooed by a man whose entire life seems built upon and dedicated to lies, hatred, self-aggrandization, and conning the people rather than conning the helm. Come on, Joe. Let's go make America great.